Hello respected seniors and the college. Today I am going to present laparoscopic transabdominal cervical cerclage. A brief history of the patient. She is a 26-year-old female, Gravida 5A4 with 13 weeks of pregnancy. She had a history of recurrent second trimester abortion, mostly they are between 16 to 24 weeks of pregnancy. She had a failed vaginal cerclage in her last pregnancy. On per-speculum examination, cervix has taken up, external os was specialis. Cervix was soft, short in size, less than 1 cm. In a pre-operative investigation, routine blood investigation has done, thyroid profile to rule out any mid-trimester abortions, USG ops with anti-scan to rule out any congenital anomalies and the trisomy in a baby, double marker to add the anti-scan, and the routine consent has taken along with the possibility of abortion has also taken. There are 5 steps of the surgery. First step is dissection of vesico-cervical space. Second step is creation of window in a broad ligament. Third is placing the muscle tape around the cervix. Fourth is tying a knot anteriorly. And fifth is closing the anterior peritoneum. The patient is placed in a supine position with an extended head low. 10 mm supra-umbilical port with a 5.5 mm lateral port has placed. On entering the abdomen, peritoneal cavity has inspected. The uterus was 12 to 14 weeks in size. The first step of the surgery is to open the uterovesical fold of the peritoneum. The bladder has demarcated. Anterior fold of the peritoneum is simply cauterized. We have a bipolar in the right hand and the scissor in the left hand. The cauterization is started. Anterior peritoneum is cut. The incision has extended. Small bladder fiber, simply cauterize and the cut. The loose areolar tissue is dissected down caudally to expose the cervico-ischemic junction. The peritoneal incision is extended laterally. For traction, we ask our assistant to give a gentle traction cranially with a simple ball forceps with jaws open. Giving a traction in such a cases is always been a difficult task, as this uterus is having a baby inside. It is more soft, more vascular, so you have to be very cautious while giving attractions, and you should be more gentle as far as maneuvering of uterus is concerned. A simple bladder fiber again, it just simply cauterize and the cut, and bladder has dissected down caudally. The small burst of bipolar. Never try and push the bipolar pedal too hard. Now the dissection has proceeded. On the left side, the anterior peritoneum has opened. Now the dissection is proceeded towards the posterior broad ligament. Slowly try and dissect the posterior broad ligament. The dissection has continued lateral to the left vascular bundle. The window has created in a posterior broad ligament. The window has extended. The assistant is asked to catch the cut edge of the left broad ligament. The dissection is proceeded posteriorly. Posterior peritoneum is just coagulated and the cut, and the skeletonization of the uterines has done. We feel this is the most important step. This will prevent the vascular injury to the uterine bundle while passing a needle through the cervical tissue. Again, the same dissection is continued on the right side. Anterior peritoneum just coagulated and the cut. Again the small blood fiber, simply cauterize and the cut. Always try and stay above the pubovesico-cervical fascia, as most of the blood vessels and the veins are stay below the pubovesico-cervical fascia. If you stay above the fascia, it will never bleed. You can easily appreciate the large blood vessels at the bladder base. Now the window has created in a right broad ligament. Posteriorly, the window has extended. Again, the same step, skeletonization of the right uterine vessels has done. Next step is putting the Marcellin tape around the cervix. The needle is grabs anterior 2/3 and the posterior 1/3. We are using 5 mm by 30 cm Marcellin tape. The needle is passed through the cervico-isthmic junction, just medial to the left vascular bundle. You can easily see the pulsation of the left uterine artery. Needle holder in the left hand has a great help. It has passed through the left broad ligament window. It help in stabilization of the cervix, as well as it help in passing the needle through the cervix. The needle is grasped now. The needle is grasped with the left needle holder, delivered out through the left window anteriorly. Left adnexa has lifted and Marcellin tape has delivered out through a window. Always grasp the Marcellin tape, never grasp the needle. The assistant has asked to lift the uterus gently anteriorly. Now the Marcellin tape has transferred from posterior to anterior side of the peritoneum through the right broad ligament. Most of the surgeons prefer to straighten the needle while passing through the cervical tissue, but in our experience, the curvature of the needle giving a great leverage and advantage of passing the needle through the cervical tissue. Now again on the right side, the needle is passed through the cervico-isthmic region. The needle holder in the left hand again help in stabilizing the cervix and also help in passing the needle through the cervical tissue, just medial to the left vascular bundle. Again the Marcellin tape has delivered out. The needle has cut. The two end of the Marcellin tape is now adjusted. First knot was the always a surgical knot. You always prefer ipsilateral suturing. It's a personal choice. You can do the contralateral suturing also. Never tie the knot too tightly. Just approximation of the tissue is required. First knot is always the surgical knot, followed by 4 square knot. Excess of Marcellin tape is cut and delivered out. Fifth and the last step of the surgery is to close the anterior peritoneum with Vicryl number 1 in a continuous suture. This will help to prevent the bowel adhesions post-operative and also prevent the internal herniation through the broad ligament window. Our all patients receive routine post-op care and usually discharge on a post-op day 2. We usually prefer to give the tocolysis and the injection of progesterone routinely to all our patient, though it is quite debatable, but it's working absolutely well for us. Before discharge of the patient, we always prefer to do the sonography to know the viability of the fetus and to rule out presence of any retroplacental bleed or clot. We discharge the patient on tablet progesterone Standard antenatal care was provided by referring obstetrician or by ourselves. We intended to perform the lower segment cesarean section at 36 to 38 weeks and leave the band in C2. Here you can easily appreciate the Marcellin tape just above the uterus sacrals. After going through various literature and various papers which were published, transabdominal cerclage has a very successful outcome in a patient with a classical history of cervical insufficiency, absent cervix, short cervix, or traumatized cervix, scarred cervix, which preclude the chances for the transvaginal cerclage. In fact, some of the studies clearly mention laparotomy and the laparoscopy in a transabdominal cerclage has no significant difference as far as obstetric outcome is concerned. Several studies has mentioned laparoscopy has a clear edge over the laparotomy as far as short hospitalization, less postoperative pain and fast recovery has concerned. So transabdominal cerclage performed by laparoscopy seems to be the feasible technique in case where transvaginal cerclage failed or technically impossible. I hope you like my video. If you have any queries or any doubt, you can email me or you can do the WhatsApp. Thanks a lot.